story to tell. After 1945, Kurt Tank, creator of the famous folk group FW-190, went to Argentina. There, he worked on jet fighters before coming to India with a lot of research materials. He used an aircraft limited, or HAL, worked with Tank on a particularly sleek new fighter jet, the HF-24 Marut. The HF-24 is India's first jet-powered domestic fighter. 147 Maruts were completed. The first flight was conducted on June 17, 1961. The aircraft entered service for a short time, was subsequently decommissioned from frontline service in 1985, and fully retired in 1990. The HF-24 served early in the Indian Air Force and could not be exported of any kind. Marut was identified as a single-seat fighter bomber. The plane has a length of 15.87 meters, a wingspan of 9 meters, a height of 3.60 meters, an empty weight of 6.2 tons, and a maximum takeoff weight of 10.9 tons. The HF-24 Marut had a pretty similar appearance to the Maruts family's design, with the low-mounted delta wing configuration. Air intakes were located on either side of the fuselage, behind the pointed nose. The pilot sat in a glass cockpit with good visibility to the front and sides. The tail section consisted of a large vertical tail fin and two horizontal planes. The HF-24 appeared to be a mix of a few different aircraft concepts. It used two British-made jet engines, the Bristol Siddeley Orpheus Mark 703 turbojets, with 21.6 kN thrust each. Marut could reach a top speed of Mach 0.93, combat radius of 396 km, rate of climb of 22.5 meters per second, and service ceiling of 12,000 meters. In terms of weapons, Marut was armed with four 30mm 18 cannons with 120 rounds each. It could carry retractable mitra pack 68mm rockets or up to 1.8 tons of bombs on four wing pylons. At the time of Marut's conception, the Indian aerospace industry was limited, lacking the infrastructure and scientific base to successfully produce an efficient indigenous fighter. Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, HAL, was heavily dependent on foreign technology and imported components. The Marut was not only heavily dependent on foreign-sourced materials, but was more expensive to manufacture the type in India than to have imported completed aircraft. The level of indigenous competence increased over time, reportedly reaching 70% by December 1973. The allocation of scarce resources to reproducing components that could have been readily imported represented a high level of opportunity cost to India. The Indian Air Force reportedly showed little confidence in indigenous fighter technology, having openly expressed its preference for the French-built Dassault Ouragan as an alternative. By the time the Marut entered mass production, the Indian Air Force had already purchased foreign-built fighters such as the Hawker Hunter and Sukhoi Su-7. Following on from the Marut, HAL proceeded to produce larger quantities of both European and Soviet combat aircraft under license, such as the Sepakat Jaguar, Mikoyan Jurovik MiG-21 and Mikoyan MiG-27. With underpowered engines, Marut could not match the MiG-21s or Pakistani F-104 starfighters. It was not on the Indian Air Force air-to-air fighter list. The Marut was only limited to light ground attack duties. In this role, the Marut saw combat during the Indo-Pakistani War of 1971, notably participating in the Battle of Long Jawala. By 1982, the Marut was increasingly obsolescent and was gradually phased out during the late 1980s. On March 31, 1990, the last aircraft retired from the squadron. Now, Marut can only be seen as exhibits at different places in India. For example, one in Bengaluru. The story is both inspirational and chastening. It tells us what a nation's determination, ambition, and a leader's vision can achieve, as well as the challenges of producing frontline military systems and India's technology limitations. My video about Indian HF-24 Marut fighter bomber answer. Thank you for watching. If you find this video interesting, please give me your thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to support the channel. Goodbye and see you again in the next videos.